Hello everyone, my name is Ahmad and you are watching Dev Dive. Today I'll be walking you through how you can install Ollama on Linux. Either it be a local installation of Linux, or on a cloud, AWS, or you have WSL installed. Today I'll be showing you how you can install Ollama on Linux, and the Linux I have chose is Amazon Linux and it's hosted on AWS. So let's get started. So head over to your AWS console, and in the AWS console, go to the EC2 section. Once the EC2 section is loaded, click on Launch Instance. Now we have to select an instance that has an integrated GPU and an AMI that supports deep learning. So let me name it as Ollama Demo, and I'm choosing Amazon Linux, and from the AMI I'll be choosing with TensorFlow GPU, TensorFlow deep learning OSS NVIDIA driver AMI GPU TensorFlow 2.16. Now the version can vary, but you have to choose AMI GPU TensorFlow. After selecting your AMI, now you have to select your instance type. We'll be selecting G4DNXLarge. That GPU, that instance basically has an integrated GPU with it and 16 gigs of RAM. So G4DNXLarge. It'll be costing us about $0.5 an hour or $1 about 2 hours. Then you have to create a key pair. Ollama demo. After creating the key pair, just leave the security section as it is. If we have to add new inbound rules or open any ports, we'll do that later. I think 35 gigabytes is enough, or you can increase it to 50 if you like. And that's it. Now we can launch our instance. So you see, I have launched successfully a G4DNXLarge instance. Now many of you will have an issue here. It will show you that you don't have the quota or quota limit exceeded. I'll make a video on that too. But basically what you have to do is request quota limit increase. I'll tell you how to do that in a separate video. Now let's head back to our EC2 console where our instances are listed. So this is the one that I've just created. Let's click on connect. See, it gives me an SSH command, and I have this key pair with me that I installed, I downloaded. So let me create the path for that temp file. Now I can paste this command here. Now you have to see that EC2 will not allow you to log in as root user, so you have to change the username to EC2-user. Type yes. And we're connected to our console. Now, once you're in the console, now we have to install our Ollama. Go to the Ollama's official website and click on download. We're not installing it for Windows and not for Mac OS, so we'll click on Linux. It gives us a curl command. Let's copy that and make a folder here named Ollama and cd into Ollama and install it. This will take some time. Okay, now let's head back to Ollama's official website and go to search for models. Now there are many open source models that we can use, like Gemma 2, Llama 3, Llama 2 Uncensored, and Mistral. So we'll go with Llama 3. So you can just say Llama run Llama 3. This is a 4.7 gigabytes file. It will take some time, but as I'm on AWS, so it will probably take about half a minute or something. So our Llama 3 is now running. The installation was successful and we have our local LLM or Ollama installed and Llama 3 is running on it. So, hello. As you can see, this is working just fine. So I'll just shut it down by saying slash bye, and this will close the service. So you can run it again by saying Ollama run Llama 3 and it will bring that instance up. So this is how you can install Ollama on AWS or on Linux. The setup is basically same for every Linux, but you have to ensure that you have the CUDA drivers installed on that Linux instance. If not, it will be very slow, as it will be very CPU intense and it requires GPU. So it is preferable that you have GPU installed. And in Linux, you have to make sure that the drivers are properly installed. So that's it. If you like the video, like, share, comment and subscribe. Thank you very much. I'll see you in the next one.